second meeting of the Public Shade Tree Commission. I call to order. Normally, we have public comment, but there are no members of the public here, so normally the next item is approval of minutes, but I just got an email from Terry today saying that she does not have the minutes ready for us this week. So we will move on to the next item, which I'd like to make a regular thing here before we go on to anything else, which is a review of the online to-do list. So if possible, at future meetings, can people bring their laptops? Especially now that we have a hotspot and we can actually get on.
I mean, can we, can we, I bring mine so I can get on.
Yeah.
You can get on, yeah.
15 devices.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool.
But in the absence of that, I'm happy to just go down the list and.
My computer isn't much on it.
I also have it written out.
Okay.
But, yeah. Just so everyone knows.
You know what I mean?
What, Jen?
I wonder if we could project it.
Oh.
That would be the way to go.
Okay, let's see.
I suggested it to Lily just because in, on another committee I was on, a governing board for my UU church in Boston, it proved like really effective, not just for individuals, but for the group process. Not only for someone, actually it was a rotating person to keep track of to-dos as the meeting went on, but then at each subsequent meeting, to just quickly review the to-do list. So it's a real active list, just to see, has this been done? If not, does it still need to be done, or when might we anticipate it being done? It really kept things moving nicely.
Yeah, and I think it's a great idea, so I would like to adopt it as a regular thing. So to that point, since you guys don't have it, I'm happy to just verbally go down the line, and I'm gonna skip all the ones that have,
yes,
say done.
Yeah.
So this was way back September 2nd. So Rich, this is yours, and it's asking the mayor if he endorsed the revised tree ordinance?
The one that.
The one that Jesse Adams and.
Have not followed up with that.
Okay, all right.
Have not followed up with that because I don't, from what Pam told me, I don't believe that the council voted on that.
No, the council hasn't voted on it yet, but I'm sure the draft has, the mayor has seen it, and I'd be curious to know if he.
I will follow up with that.
Okay. And then the other one is, so this is related to getting all the trees that we have planted or are planning to plant on a map so that we can look at them. And.
That's in progress.
Okay. Can we have a deadline for that?
You'll probably have it by January 1st.
Okay.
Would be my guess.
So I'm gonna put the due date for January 1st.
So when you go on there, do you have to save in some way?
No, this is just a Google spreadsheet.
Okay.
Yeah, so anytime you write and you kind of click the term.
Click on something else.
It's, yeah, all right. So this, so the mayor, I'm not sure how, you know, how important this is to us. I mean, it was a little bit more relevant early on when, you know, we were, didn't have a sense of the, whether thing, this would pass. And I'm not actually sure how this made it to the to-do list, but do people still want to know whether the mayor supports this ordinance? Is this an important unit to have? I mean, of all the things Rich could be doing, does he need to try to pin down an answer from the mayor?
No, but I think he probably would say if it's been embedded by this commission.
Yeah.
And it's passed through planning, then he would probably endorse it, but I'm sure he'd probably want to read it.
Yeah.
But I will just communicate with him briefly about it.
Okay. What's a reasonable deadline for you?
I would say I could probably, I'm actually meeting with him next week, so I could probably bring it up in a meeting.
Add it to the list.
Or I could just call him and talk to him.
Okay. I'll say 12:10. All right. Rich, send to tree commissioners listed trees purchased for plantings. That's related to the whole map. Okay, so that's the same thing, 1-1. All right, going down the line. Jen and Rob, create a document for tracking tool supplies, equipment needed for tree planting. This kind of falls into an agenda item I have here, which is creating a PSTC manual, and that would be components of it. So why don't we just?
We're on it.
Okay, all right. We'll talk about it in a little greater detail. And then when we do talk about it later, let's create some deadlines for ourselves, to the extent that we can. Okay, now there's one on here which I frankly would like to see omitted, and this says, Marilyn and Lily, draft letter for Gazette response to the letter to the editor. Remember way back in the day? Feels like, you know, it doesn't feel necessary to write such a letter. I mean, if we want to talk about a late winter or an early spring op-ed piece, you know, where we talk to folks about, we just emphasize some of the public education pieces around trees, our role, things like that, I'm happy to do that. But at this point, I think that this piece should come off the to-do list. Does anyone object to that? This was to Kenneth Dim. Okay.
Oh, from the Village Hill, back Village Hill Development.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so I'm going to just delete that. All right, Jay and Rich, follow up with Wayne about establishing a tree nursery on Northampton land. That's long been done, right?
Yep. Just
I think there's another reference further down with the data.
Okay, Rich, find out where fine goes, general fund or tree fund?
Right now, the fines have all gone to the general fund miscellaneous receipts account, and we have an internal tracking mechanism at DPW. So we've made two deposits, $9,500 and $1,633.28. So when the auditor, the DOR auditor from the state gets done with what he's doing and communicates with Joyce, our auditor, there will be an account set up that we can move funds in and out of without city council approval.
Okay.
So they are still working on that. But I had to deposit the checks because they were, one of them was on the verge of being 2 months old, and it's a lot of money to hold out. So.
Okay.
So it's being tracked. It's not.
So the answer is it's in the general fund, but it's earmarked.
It's earmarked, and it's going to be removed once we have the account. So it just require a transfer from city council.
Okay, so I'm putting down on that. Thank you. All right, Jen, follow up with some vocational students regarding tree planting.
I did that.
Yeah, you did.
Several times.
You did that.
Yeah.
I would like to discuss whether or not, maybe a little bit later in the agenda, whether or not they're having any role in, in the rest of the fall plantings. You guys saw the letter that was submitted to the editor. Mm-hmm. It did make that comment. Okay, Jen and Rich. Jen sends standard information for information packets for Rich to laminate. Was there any laminating that was done?
I think we decided not to.
Yeah, we decided not to.
Yeah, to do it.
Okay, I'm taking that off. Jay, Rich, and Lily walk and view trees. I assume that means the tour that we did.
Yeah.
That was done. Okay, this was, ask Andy to update, this is Rich, ask Andy to update Google Map by next week being September 21st.
it's updated, and I do the updating as we are planting.
Okay, I'm going to skip some of these things that I
clearly
see.
I want to understand, update the Google Map, which is the map you have, and that's being transferred to a GIS map. Right?
It is, but after January 1st, when I have everything populated in there, Andy is going to take, probably going to take a day or two to put it in the GIS.
And will it then be easier to populate after it's moved?
It'll be easier to do a lot of different things. You'll actually be able to print out a spreadsheet that I'm actually all of you, and we can do a lot of different mapping techniques and have multiple layers that are much easier to use than the Google Map. It's a lot more transparent.
Let's just keep trying to go down this list and not get too involved in the details. Rich, recertify us as a Tree City USA.
In progress.
Okay, and that due date on that is?
December
31st.
31st.
Rich, email GIS info, nursery info to tree commissioners.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. I'm not even sure what
say that one. I think that was
when we broke down. You Bob and I worked on that.
Yeah, that was for the nursery.
Yeah.
I think our original, correct me if I'm wrong, Jay, but our original goal was to have provide GIS mapping for you to see the different locations that we actually looked at and talked about. Is that what that was for?
Maybe that was it.
I don't know, it's been so many moving pieces, I'm not quite sure.
We also got together and picked out the selection of trees. I don't know if that's what it's referring to.
Will you read it again?
When was that?
Okay, so this was on the 4th of November. By the way, Andrew, we're just going through the detailed to-do list, and we're going to make this just a regular part of the beginning of every meeting. It says, Rich is assigned to email GIS info, and then in parentheses it says nursery, to tree commissioner.
Yeah, I thought,
no, that's not what we,
I thought, if I remember that correctly, that there was a map of some sort when we were talking about the property.
That's probably the map that Wayne sent to Rich, that we looked at the different
the
properties.
The hard copy of?
There is a copy somewhere.
But there was electronic.
Okay, is this necessary?
Well, we don't
really know. The tree commissioners need to see that? I'm going to put NA for this one right away.
Okay.
All right, Rich, discuss Kennedy Road issue with Wayne Fiden, I assume that means.
Yes, I have not done that with him. I don't have, well, let me tell you my tree warden report's happening.
Okay.
So that is, I have not done that.
Okay, do you need a deadline on that?
The deadline for that is probably not going to be until the spring.
All right, I'm going to put 3/15/15, just to have a placeholder.
No,
3/16. You're really late on that task. And then Rich gets soil samples at nursery site.
We're in progress.
Okay, deadline?
Pretty darn soon.
Okay, we'll say 12/10.
Yeah.
I just think it would be helpful to have deadlines for all these things. Andrew, share RFPs with Rich for nursery.
I don't think I've done that yet. I can do that right now, if possible. I did send the spreadsheet that summarizes who you bought from. I can send quotes to you if that's helpful. I like the different vendors. I don't know.
Well, if you sent me the vendor name, the vendor names that you use.
Yeah.
You can send everything. I can just put it all in a binder. Just have it all, and then we can kind of sit down and sort it all out.
I guess in hindsight, we either used stuff that was on the state bid list, for big ticket items. So I didn't have to do like an RFP, it was just through standard procurement or through the state bid list for things that are more expensive. So just the contact information.
That'd be fine.
I gave that to you, and there's like a specific request about how each company was to work with. Like Rootmaker, I wasn't so crazy about, they're kind of slow. But High Caliper was like super, super easy to work with when it came to ordering the tree bags.
Okay, so
thank you.
Are you saying you've sent everything to him that you feel like you need to?
Yeah, I'd say so. When it comes to like unit costs and different suppliers, I can give, like, if we're going down that list and there's somebody that you're more interested in, I can give you the contact information.
For okay, all right.
Okay, I will put done unless it's not done, in which case I'll put 12/10.
I'll email it.
Because it sounds like you can do it quickly. All right. Lily Tom J, help with business plan for nursery. I'm happy to talk a little bit about some more of the research I'm undergoing, but it sounds to me like there might be a meeting that needs to be had between the three of us and Rich in that respect. So it's coming up on the holidays. Could we realistically have a meeting before the holidays about that?
For me, to be honest with you, it all depends on the weather.
Okay.
I mean, we can make.
So why don't we schedule something?
We can schedule something, but if I back out.
Yeah, that's why.
During the day meeting, I could do that.
Yeah, if Jay can. I mean, if Todd can. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm going to put a deadline to schedule.
You going to send out a doodle poll, Lily?
I can do something like that.
Okay.
There's not many of us, so I might be able to just do it by email. Maybe if we have a little bit of time at the end of the day, at least three of us can come up with a date.
So what's the goal of that?
Well, I don't know yet. I guess it's just to start the discussion of what a business plan looks like. I had hoped to do some, I still feel like there's some background research that could be done before we launch directly into a business plan, but and I can talk a little bit about that in my chair report. But I guess the goal is to present a plan that the mayor would approve that makes a compelling case for allocating resource, city resources to the development of the nursery.
That implies that it wouldn't just come out of the tree budget?
That's the part that's confusing for me, because if we already have funding, it's not, I think all you need is the approval for the land use, correct?
Well, the land would need to be developed a little bit.
Yeah.
I think there may be two pieces to this. I don't know if you want to get into this.
I don't, actually. So how about we might have some time under any other business.
Okay.
So why don't I just put nursery? By the way, I have scheduled this so that we end this meeting at 5:30. I actually have to go do a pretty long-distance carpool thing tonight. So I'm going to make sure we stay on track and try to end the meeting a little bit early. Okay, so Rob and Jim, thank you to volunteers. I actually didn't see that come across the web.
Rob and I met, I don't know, before Thanksgiving, and I just have not had time. We divided up the tasks. I know what I need to do, and I have not done it yet.
Can I make a suggestion? If you want, in the interest of expediency, what you could do is you could just cut and paste the Gazette letter that was sent, and then just write a little blurb above that says, "Hey, folks, just, you know, this was our big shout out to you guys. You know, fantastic job. Job is done."
Yeah, we have two. One is to the volunteers that we didn't use, that were in the SurveyMonkey, which I feel pretty strongly that we need to make some contact with them if we're trying to have an ongoing group of people that are going to be interested in assisting us. We can't have them just shouting into the
void.
Yes, right. Yeah. So that, okay. Yeah. And I think you were going to do a thank you to the folks that we did use, right?
Okay.
I have it all written down, but yes, it was two different letters and then also the manual.
Okay. What's your deadline on the letters?
I think
time's of the essence here.
I'll go with Jen on my deadline.
I can probably, let me think if I was to go to a swimming this weekend. I could probably do it by the end of the weekend.
Okay.
So can I just offer something that might help you out a little bit?
Yeah.
We have the ability to process large quantities of paper and envelopes and labels. So if you, I think that would help you out to make it go quicker.
Oh, it's mostly just an email. We were just going to
do
email.
By email?
Yeah, yeah.
Not a true thank you.
Don't actually have people's
address.
This is true.
Okay. It's a whole new world. We may never know where they live.
Okay, all right. So I'm putting the deadline as 12/6/15.
Okay, so hold on.
Okay, so 12/6. So then we should, if you would, leave time this weekend for one to contact, to work together.
Even on the phone or something, yeah.
Contact.
Yeah.
Does anybody think the mayor?
Good question. Well, the letter to the editor mentioned the mayor, so we didn't make a direct thanks to the mayor.
I mean,
coming out and everything?
Coming out, providing funding, backing up Rob when people are angry, not Rob Rich when people are angry.
Yeah.
They're angry at Rob too.
Yeah, angry at both of them. One or the other. I think it's important.
I agree. I'm happy to, actually, do you want me to create a card on behalf
we can
of
just pass it
the
around.
Tree commission and we can, okay.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. Okay.
Personal touch.
So that can go on the to-do list.
Yep.
And you can assign me to that, and I'll bring it to the next meeting. Yeah. Okay, so let's see what else we have. Marilyn, begin interpreting and writing report on fall tree survey. So you've already begun.
Yes, in process.
But let me change that to interpret and write report, and let's have a deadline for that.
Well, the raw statistics will be ready by the end of December, and the first draft of the report will be done by the end of January. Is my rough
time. So I'll put
1/6. The Google spreadsheet that one can still access on Monkey, that won't be available. We'll just have PDFs or something.
We downloaded a CSV file.
We'll have a CSV file.
Yeah.
So we'll still be able to manipulate the data.
Yeah. We're aware that that's expiring.
Because I just saw the data for the people who want trees and stuff.
Yeah. Okay, and actually that's, there might be some additions to that, because I only got as far into the survey, downloading that information, as there were data responses at that point in time, and then since then more have come in. All right, so then we've got, so we've got a few to get through here. Okay. Rich, set up revolving account for tree commission. Is that right, for tree commission?
No, that would be wrong, and then you can erase that whole thing, because that's what we're working on about 15 lines farther up.
Okay. Deleted?
Just delete, yeah.
It says, Rich and Rob, meet on 11/19 to discuss remaining tree planting.
Done.
Okay. Please. So is Tree City USA, that's a duplication. I'm getting rid of that. Talk with building commissioner regarding trench permit edits.
Yeah, I think the trench permit aspect of it is DPW. Building permits are what I would need to review with Louis.
Okay.
But I think this is kind of a bigger conversation piece because of this situation at 623 Kennedy Road, kind of is a good example of the dysfunction of how everyone communicates with each other in the very beginning. We could have avoided a lot of heartache if I was communicating with someone from planning and the building commissioner all at the same time in the beginning.
Okay.
So that's a conversation that we're going to have. And that means trying to get everybody together. And it won't be a challenge, but the question is that how are we going to move forward? What kind of process are we going to put in place to make sure that there's a red flag brought up in the beginning and not a red flag at the end, which is what I'm dealing with at the moment.
Okay. All right, so is that an agenda item I should put on a future? And or is there someone that one of us should be speaking to or inviting to this committee?
I think we've both heard from Wayne and Louie. I think it would be better suited if we had just a small meeting, an internal meeting of some sorts, to try to hash this out.
Okay.
I don't necessarily think we can actually hash it out at a... Well, we could. We could invite both of them to come, and we could all communicate in one room together as a commission and as city officials.
It does seem more of an internal administrative thing, though, doesn't it?
I agree. It does. It's just how we communicate about how things are done and what the process is and how, because there was no tree warden for so long, there was no reason to put it in front of the tree warden.
Right.
Now we put it in front of the tree warden, but unfortunately it comes at the end of the planning board approving this process for this person's driveway. It's just a good example. So, I can make internal changes at DPW pretty easily because the trench permits we issue all the trench permits.
Yeah.
And this, so I have done some of that.
But yeah.
The bigger thing is, the whole process of actually from submitting a plan to planning to modify your property to build a driveway, for example, that is in a water protection district that is within 100 feet of a intermittent stream.
Ooh.
Planning all has to work on all that. Once planning approves it with the conditions, then it goes to DPW for approval.
So is there a role that we can play in this? I mean, do you want us to draft a potential like flowchart? Would that be helpful? Or do we just need to back out? Do we need to just gently nudge you to make sure this gets done? Or do we need to do nothing?
I think at the moment we'd probably leave it in there to keep me nudged.
Okay.
And then I will carry the ball and try to actually sit down with Wayne and Louie to try to figure out if we can get an internal staff person to actually make a flow chart for us that actually understands the present function that we have, what it looks like, and then maybe once we see that, then we can say, okay, this is what we think it should look like, and can we change this?
Okay. Would you like a deadline for that?
Sure, let's make it February.
Okay.
Please.
All right, so what I'm calling this is talk with building commissioner and city planner regarding a flow chart that includes trees in the permitting process. Or includes tree warden?
Yes, tree warden in the actual site plan review.
Okay.
Is really what it should be.
In site plan review. And so it's both the city planner and the building commissioner?
Correct.
Okay, got it.
Please, thank you.
Todd, create structure for tree protection policy. That's very broad, but really I just want him to be holding the hole whenever there's a potential nugget for changing or creating stronger ordinances related to trees. I want him to be holding that and then eventually drafting language. So I don't know what kind of deadline to give that one. Let me just write a question mark and consult him. Let's see, what else do we have? Let's see, J. Todd, Mira, help Lily start research for nursery chart and process. Okay, that's all related to the question of the nursery. And I'd like to do that a lot in January. So I'm gonna put the deadline as 1/31.
I think the one before that, I wrote that in, but it's only me. It's not like all three of us.
Tree protection policies to Todd.
Like I sent mine to Todd, but I didn't send anybody else's.
Oh, I see, okay. So what does this mean, tree protection policy?
So Jay has a tree protection policy in the bid documents at Smith. I had one that I generated.
So this is Dick, Smith, and then Rich would be just the city? It says Jay, Rich, and Jen.
Yeah, and we were supposed to send the language we had to Todd.
Okay.
So I found it in my computer and sent it to him.
I see. So Jay, when do you think you can have that done by?
I can do that by Friday.
Okay. Lily and Marilyn meet to review SurveyMonkey. That's been done. Marilyn, send volunteer information from SurveyMonkey to Todd. Sorry, to Rob.
It's not quite done, but I'll have that done by the end of Sunday night.
Great. I did receive a link to the people requesting a tree already. I don't know what form you're going to put it in.
I'll send you an update.
Okay, and then there's the volunteers.
Yes.
Those are the two big questions.
We're almost through here, guys. Thank you for your patience. It says, Jen and Rob, begin plan for spring tree planting. Uh-huh. I think that's part of a larger conversation about what we're gonna do in the spring too. So
yep.
Maybe you wanna at least be shaping some ideas of what that might look like.
But yeah, we're a little backlogged. This is the, you know, it's a huge project.
Yeah.
And like, you know, I don't know.
Well, I think it,
I still haven't finished the stuff from it's just a lot of work. And
okay. I do think it begs the question of, are we ready to do spring tree planting? Or is, you know.
I think that.
I don't want to get too much into this discussion.
Yeah, I think we could, we could do that. Well, the spring tree planting won't be very large, I'm thinking, because we don't have anything. Very many trees on hand to plant.
Okay.
So
if we just draw down what we have, it's a more manageable project.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think that's the answer to that question. Then the next question is the fall planting. That's all different question. That we can maybe leave off for the moment.
That's not even on the list yet.
Right. Well, I mean, except that we need to go back to some of the people who supply the trees and tell them that we're going to want some trees. Or
not go to those same suppliers.
Well, I want to talk about this just in sort of broader scope of what some trees need and what they don't need, is that some trees function better if they're planted in the spring. So if there's some species that we want to plant, you don't have to plant 80 all at once, but if you do 40 trees in the spring and 40 trees in the fall, that's not, and it doesn't, maybe it doesn't have to be a volunteer intensive thing. Like maybe if we're working with, I don't know what your crew's capabilities are or what their goals are, but I think it's important to just recognize that availability of some stock is not always guaranteed. Different trees have different needs, and you don't have to use volunteers all the time to get trees in the ground. So if we want to plant, you know, say, you know, 20, 30, 40 trees in the spring, that's not an unrealistic goal, especially when there's a crew of people who can't work on it.
I'm going to stop you there. I'm going to stop this conversation. I'm sorry, but this is really about a to-do list. So I just want to assign deadlines to topics, And I'm going to put that on any other business.
The problem with the to-do list is that it's hard to plan a spring tree planting if we don't have some...
So let's talk about it later.
Commitment on the, today.
Okay, I hear you. So let's, I'm putting it under any other business and we'll try to give a little time for that.
Okay.
And I'm gonna put a question mark by that because you're clearly, I mean, there's some uncertainty around it. Okay, Lily, work on door hangers for tree planting, that is underway.
Oh, wait, please, say again. Lily, work on...
Work on door hangers for tree planting. Door hangers for, sorry, for, actually it should be tree watering. You know, when we plant a tree, we hang a door hanger on the nearby neighbor's door asking them if they water the tree.
Okay, so, I mean, there is an issue of tree planting door hangers too, but that's, can be separate.
For setback planting.
Yeah.
Okay, oh, I see, yeah, that's not what I was working on.
Why not do both?
They're different, but it's, yeah, but we could do both, it just takes time. I'm actually not a graphic design person, so I'm kind of gonna have to figure out how to make this look pretty.
Should I look for someone to do that?
Actually, can I make a suggestion?
Yeah.
I sent you an email today, I don't know if you've got it or not.
Yeah, I did get it.
Smith Vocational has a graphic design department.
Oh, that's right.
That does all of DPW letterhead.
Okay, I will send them samples of what the old, with the Worcester door hangers look like and all the content, and we'll see how they do with it.
You can?
Yeah.
This is for setback.
You and I can both go over there together.
Okay.
And I can issue to Mike Furman.
Okay.
This is
for setback. Yeah, it's probably better, it's going to be more effective if you meet him in person, I think.
Okay.
Well, this is for setback planting.
No, this is for watering. In the spring, we want to make sure all the trees that we just planted get watered.
Right, I guess I'm just asking if when you go there and you're doing this, do you want to do another one for setback?
I can mention it. I don't think that it necessarily has to be at the exact same time, but I can say we'll have more material down the road. Will you be interested in helping us with that too?
Okay. Why wouldn't you want to do something for setback planting? It just doesn't make sense. Like if we have trees, like why wouldn't you want to do outreach?
I'm not saying we wouldn't want to.
No, you can. I think what we're trying to make sure that we end up having people. Would be helpful if we had these door hangers, and then in this coming spring, which would be really important. I can actually put the door hangers out, or volunteers can walk around and put these door hangers out for this time.
Well, it'll be
because we need to get these trees watered by folks for this coming growing season.
Yeah,
is what I understand.
It's just a matter of triaging.
But we also can ask them to help design a flyer as well that we could actually stuff in the UV utility building.
Okay.
And we might actually want to take a look at what Amherst did just to, I hate to keep copying what
Amherst. It's okay.
But if it works.
Right, no kidding, right?
I'm all for copying good ideas. All right, my deadline for that is going to be probably sometime in January. I'll say 1/15. Rich and Jay, begin tree pruning process. I think that just means the process of training people to do tree pruning. This does not have to be high priority, so if you want to put a deadline of 6 months from now, that's fine.
I don't think Paige would like that. Paige doesn't need any training, but I think the whole tree pruning.
If it feels low priority, we'll just make it.
Do you know what they did in Fall River, or if you want to know what they did out there? They had like a citizen training program where they put them through like four or five different workshops, and they got like a piece of paper saying that they'd gone to the workshop and they're allowed to do basic pruning. Like if there was just a branch that was in a wrong spot, they were like citizen pruners.
Yeah.
They would go.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. I've seen that in a number of Philadelphia has that. DC has that.
No, I think, the late Emily Hamilton used to work for Davey, was talking about that.
Yeah.
So Philadelphia, too.
Yeah. So what kind of deadline, without getting going deeply, this is going to be an exercise in discipline, because we're going to do this every single week, and this task, this to-do list could devolve into the meeting itself. So we want to make sure we don't let it. I'm sorry to be so strict about this, but...
I'm not sure we need to do it every week.
Yeah,
I would say put it way off. I don't think we have the management of volunteers set up yet to be able to start a whole other project.
I'll say 2017. And done.
Nice.
We do this quarterly.
Is it that painful?
Well, see what
The thing is, it's reminding us of stuff that we really need to do. We could do it every other week, but I think it's really important. Lily, follow up with friends group, that's done.
Is that right? In February.
And then last one, Marilyn.
Come up with some sort of idea about it.
Yes, I meant, I gave that stuff to.
Is that right?
Done, okay.
I guess what I don't like about it is it's being used as a way of like.
Between us.
Cutting off, we're talking about discussion, we're talking about.
Rob, we're trying to have one conversation.
I guess I just don't like the fact that it's being used as a way of cutting off discussion about things that are interesting.
Well, what I'm doing when those conversations are interesting and important is I'm trying to say, let's find a place for them in the meeting agenda.
Yeah.
And I also, I welcome agenda topics every week. So if there's a topic that feels important to you, please let me know and I'm happy to put it in the agenda. I hear you. I understand that feeling, Andrew.
It doesn't have to take this long either because we went through September through.
Yeah, I think it's going to.
Because really, it's just a matter of going through the list that was generated the previous meeting. And then maybe once a month or quarterly, we can then go back, okay, for the whole quarter, let's review it. But going forward, it could just be, all right, we had 5 things from the last meeting.
Or couldn't you just go through and pick out the ones that are near due or due?
Yeah. I skipped over the ones that we had already done, but and we just populated this with many things that are now done, so right. It won't be nearly
but
as
even long. Aside from the ones that are done, things that are more distant, you don't have to review them necessarily.
Yeah, I mean, there's a number that we won't even need to mention next.
Right.
Okay, so on to the chair report.
Okay, can I do a quick introduction, if possible? You went to that tree workshop that PVC put on. I have the minutes, I forwarded them, I don't know if I forwarded them to you.
I think I forwarded them to everybody.
Okay. It was not really, it was mostly geared towards stormwater, you know? So it's interesting from a stormwater standpoint, but it wasn't really geared towards like how do you reforest a community.
Yeah.
You
know? What I found interesting is that you might spend $10,000 to create a substitute for a storm drain with a, yep, with a sump, basically. And then that might be $10,000, and then you end up with a small,
yeah,
and temporary tree.
You're not getting big shade trees.
So even though you just spent $10,000 to create this beautiful sort of biosystem, you end up with one small tree. And that tree is good for about 20 years, and then it has to be scrapped, basically. 30.
Really?
So it was not encouraging in terms of planting trees for us, because the way in our world, uh-huh, we see it, in terms of planting trees in connection with stormwater sort of infrastructure, direct infrastructure. It was very important in terms of cutting down on the need for stormwater drains, because if you have a lot of canopy, that's not. But that's just the kind of planting.
Okay. All right. Well, I have to say, I read your notes and I thought that it sounded pretty interesting. So
it wasn't.
To hear that. Okay. The one thing about your notes that I really got lost on, there's so many acronyms,
yeah,
that are just second nature to you, but I had no idea.
Andrew took the notes. I was watching him sitting next to him. I mean, just keeping up with, because they use that, it was all acronyms, and
yeah,
it was tough for me to, but I did come away with that takeaway, and it's been a way effective.
I think the takeaway is that using, I don't think stormwater tree planters are something that if we're like a public shade tree commission, that we should really like go after, you know, for these stormwater boxes, because it sounds like a cool sort of biofilter way of making your landscape softer. But the bioswales and I guess like the curb inlets and basically just kind of working to treat stormwater in the right of way using bioswales sounds a lot more interesting, but I don't think there's like a large shade tree component to it.
Okay.
There's interesting soils and plants, but we're okay, not going to get big trees out of it.
Okay, that's good to know. Thank you for that. I actually did have that on my chair report list to ask you guys about that. Okay, so I wanted to mention Marilyn and I met today to discuss SurveyMonkey. We got a good plan for that in Mira too. I'm still, I contacted Molly Freilicher about sourcing trees and just the whole conversation about what are the best ways to source a tree for a municipality our size, given our, you know, budget, given our goals. And she gave some very good information. She directed me to a community, Lexington, that has had a tree nursery for 8 years.
For 8 years?
Yeah. And so I've reached out to them. I've not heard back from them yet, but I just wanted to interview them and say, how's it going? You know, is this, was this, a, you know, 8 years into it, does it feel like a good use of your time and resources? Mm-hmm. They have a very vibrant tree committee. I went to the website. You're welcome to go there too. Lexington City, their city website has a big page with lots of subpages on their tree committee. And I'd just like to maybe even go out there and visit them because they look like they're getting a lot of stuff done. So that's where I am in that. And Molly also directed me to the, Andrew, you may know this person, the Chicopee tree warden or their direct, you know, planning director or something. They just did a big tree planting of bare root. And
Chicopee?
Yeah, and it was very successful. And it's actually featured in, you know, do you all get the Forester magazine? Mm-hmm. I recommend that you get on this. So DCR, their Urban Forestry Department, sends out a monthly, it's called the Urban
Citizen Forester,
right. And they mentioned Chicopee this.
What's it called, City Forester?
Citizen Forester.
Citizen.
Molly puts it out.
Yeah. So I thought I'd talk to them too and find out where they source their bare root trees. So that's where I am on that. And then let's see what else we have. Oh, I wanted to mention, Rich.
Yes.
I sent you guys the city press release and it was featured in the Gazette today that Ned Huntley is moving to East Hampton to go back to his work as a city engineer, and the DPW director position will soon be vacant. And I just want to hear from you whether what the process for hiring the next director will be, and whether or not we want to consider writing a letter to the mayor related to the importance of a director appreciating green infrastructure.
I think writing a letter to the mayor would be good. I think we should probably wait until probably after the first of the year, because Mr. Huntley will be here till the end of December. So the process of hiring a DPW director has not been laid out. Senior staff is going to be meeting with the mayor next week, which I think that you probably saw in the press release, mm-hmm. to communicate about what's going to happen in the interim after the first of the year, and who will be the acting director during the search process. So, the mayor, I don't believe, has set any timelines at this particular moment, but he's working on them. So, but I think it would be good for the Public Safety Tree Commission to for the mayor to hear your voice about how you feel that we need to have someone who's a DPW director to be proactive when it comes to tree care. Fortunately for us, we have at this particular time, we have a really good mayor who's very supportive of that. So I think that would be one of his many things on his agenda for interviewing the next director, at least I would hope.
Okay.
And I'd have to say, I can speak from experience that was not on the last, because I was part of the last hiring process screening committee as a foreman, and that was not one of the questions.
It was broader than that. It was about green.
But
you're right. It wasn't specific.
It wasn't specific to the functions of the department.
Uh-huh. Yep. Okay, how do others feel about that? Do you like that idea about writing a letter to the mayor? Mm-hmm.
Is that a process that citizens are
open to? If it's done similar to the one that we had the last time, when the final candidates were drawn down out of a pool, there should be two. We had a meet and greet at the Garden House, but I don't.
You know,
that was different.
That was because there was a group of citizen activists who were really pushing to be involved in that process, and so I think that the former mayor kind of humored / accommodated us. I don't know if that's typical for when the final candidates for a high high-ranking position or...
They did with the police chief just recently.
That's true.
Yep.
Did they do it with multiple candidates?
I think for the last two, there was like a meet and greet with the community.
There was a meet and, I think there was a meet and greet, but there wasn't, like for the fire chief, there was not, because the fire chief was picked right out of the ranks.
Well, and the other thing, with, last time with the DPW director, was there was a committee formed to review the candidates.
Correct, there, which was a citizen committee, and if you're interested in being on, I'm sure you could, if the mayor chooses to, I think he'll eventually have a press release to explain how he's going to fill that position, what process he's going to use, or not. It's entirely up to the mayor, because it's a little different this time around, because the director reports directly to the mayor.
Right.
And this previous, when Ned was hired, Ned reported to the Board of Public Works, and that has totally changed, because the Board of Public Works is now not, is a commission like you are, or like you folks are. It's not a policymaking board. They can make recommendations, they can, all they can do is make recommendations, they don't approve contracts anymore, they don't set water and sewer rates, and the director, nor does anyone in the department answer to them, they all answer to the mayor. So it's a little different setup, so it'll be interesting. I think some of those things will be talked about when we have our meeting next week, so if the mayor is, I mean, I can kind of, I can ask any kind of question, so if anybody wants to ask any question you want me to ask, I'd be more than happy to ask if you want to forward them to me.
Okay.
If you think of anything, if not, then just wait.
I have a question for you.
Are we going to talk about tree sourcing research?
Yeah.
Is that complete? I would like to talk more about that, though, because I think...
Okay.
I did more research into the bare root stuff.
Yeah.
And I think it works for some trees, and I think we should pursue for some trees, but some of the better trees that I like and that do really well in urban settings, even Cornell says that they don't, that they're difficult to transplant. And, you know, and like, I understand like there's an urgency, you know, to move through the meeting, but I don't, I think it's like a really important point to, I mean, I know like, okay, so Chicopee did something cool, but at the same time, I don't think if we're going to link ourselves to just this one method, which I don't support at all.
I don't think anyone has said that.
Well, then I would like to finish what I'm saying. But I think the important thing is, then I don't think I'm crazy about the tree species that function well under the bare method itself. So I think obviously I've bought, you know, over 1,000 trees now from nurseries, and the time to discuss like when you are going to buy it and what you're going to buy is now.
Uh-huh.
So, I mean, you need to be placing orders, getting the front queue to get the good stuff. And personally, I really firmly believe that if we're going to be spending, you know, taxpayer dollars, you know, that they should go to local businesses and not to, you know, somebody in another state. That if we have good relationship with local nurseries and we know they have a good product, you know, why not buy from them, or why not work to get those trees from them so we're supporting our local economy? I really think it's kind of short-sighted to invest in, you know, a large number of trees that might not be that great or that diverse. So from my perspective, I really think let's try out this new method, but there's a lot of other interesting trees that just, according to them, won't function very well. So, I mean, now, if there is some discussion of whether or not we're planting trees in the spring, personally, I feel like you have a mayor, you have a budget, you have a department head who's encouraging of this. A lot of times,
and volunteers,
a lot of communities, they spend years getting to that point. They develop these plans. They do all sorts of public outreach work to get to the point where somebody's willing to say, yes, let's form a committee, and yes, let's get some money allocated to this community so they can plant trees. So I really feel like missing a spring would be a missed opportunity. And I'm not saying you have to swing for the fences and plant 100 trees. I really think you're missing out on the planting season, which is now, for acquiring, sourcing, and getting things done. And then you can say that it's not all squeezed into this one fall planting season. And I really think that you can do both. You can plan, and you can also plan. And I think there is, like, yes, there's urgency on my part because it's something that I care about, but also I don't think many other towns are this well situated to have a lot of things lining up. You know, and I think that's an important thing to seize that opportunity, you know, and to pursue.
To reinforce that, I just want to say that Amherst Nursery, which is local, where the trees cost just a little bit more than bare root trees, although they're smaller, the trees there are like $109, $110 bare root with shipping, they're like $88. So it's pretty good, it's financially very, it works good. I know Andrew thinks pretty well of the felt bag system, which they offer. And John, who's there, who I've gotten to know, is basically saying, if you tell me what you want, you don't even have to buy it, but I have to, like, begin to put stuff aside for you. In other words, he needs a relationship where he has some confidence that we're going to put in an order in soon, in a reasonable length of time, so that he can, if he even wants some insight into what we're doing longer term. Though, for the spring, if we want plans for spring or fall, if we don't talk to him, we'll be right back to where we were this last year, where we go and we just say, what do you have? And that's what we take. Which, mm-hmm. you know, in a way, was okay this year in that we hadn't planted, there hadn't been very many trees planted, so whatever we planted were a relatively new sprinkling of whatever they were. It wasn't like we were planting what we had on top of similar plantings of the same age. So I guess from a practical point of view, I support what Andrew's saying, and I guess I keep bringing it up kind of at the wrong moment, just because I want to go right back and I have to go talk to John anyway, because we're leaving plants there over the winter, and I want to make sure they're labeled so we can find them again. But in going back there, I want to say to him, yeah, we're going to want a bunch of plants in the spring, a bunch in the fall.
Okay, so I would like to put this as a topic that requires more discussion at the next meeting, so we have plenty of time. In the meantime, I would like people feel, first of all, I just want to make clear that I'm not proposing any either or options. I'm proposing for us to do research and make data-driven decisions. And so I'm happy to bring together all of the research people have regarding sourcing trees. And then I would like to have a time to discuss it, that we can actually have a good, healthy discussion with the research in front of us. So I'm going to put that on the agenda for the next meeting, that we have a nice half an hour topic about it. And I would like people to bring as much information to the table about the nurseries. We had a lot of complaints about the tree stock that we had this fall. You know, the limited varieties, the root balls being, you know, root bound, and the weight of them, and so we just don't want to repeat the mistakes that we had this fall. And that's my hope.
Very much shifted away from what the stock that we got last fall.
Okay, great.
Right?
So I would like everyone to bring to the table next week, just some the next time we meet, as much research as you can about how we're going to source trees. I just want to make really clear, I have no agenda. I just want us to make good decisions and use our city's resources efficiently.
I think in terms of bringing data, there's already a consensus that we're not buying B&B trees. Is that right?
When I say data, I mean specific nurseries, you know, what like their stock lists are, right, you know, just as much detail as you can.
But they don't give you the stock list.
But wait, I guess if we're going to get these lists of what? I mean, trees that are B&B? No, right?
We've already talked about limiting B&B, so we're talking about grow bags, bare root. I don't know what other options there are. Grow bags and bare root?
I think it's grow bags and bare root.
And I hear you about local nurseries. In theory, I support that too, as long as they're good stock, as long as they have, you know, and they're reasonably priced and good stock. So if you demonstrate that those are you've got those in local nurseries, then I'm not averse to it. I just like to take the time. I'm not feeling the urgency that you are about planting in spring, because I'm feeling the urgency about doing a really good tree inventory in 2016. Well, that's my priority personally.
I kind of thought that's what we agreed to financially too. We're talking about money. I don't think we're going to have much money if this goes through to spend on trees.
Yeah.
So I thought that's why we weren't really.
Well, I brought that up and asked that last time, because when we talk about letters to the volunteers and the sort of volunteer momentum, it's important to know if there's going to be a long-term effort next year, even now, because you know we've got something already developed and working. So that's why now is the time.
So I like Lily's idea of actually coming to the table with a bunch of different thoughts on how to get this all done. I do agree with Lily that the tree inventory will take precedence, I think, next year. However, that's really not going to involve more of my time, and Andy's time and other DPW staff's time.
But when we don't have your time, Rich?
Right, I understand that, but the other issue is finances, and that's really going to be driven, because if we decide that we want to plant trees next fall, I'll just leave this, I'm not going to go too far into this, if we decide we want to plant trees next fall, we're going to have to place an order at the middle to end of this winter with someone. Once their stock list comes out, we have to place it, and then we have to buy it, because they're not going to hold the stock forever for us, because it's going to fly off the shelves.
Yeah.
So with that said, hopefully we'll hear sometime this winter about the DCR grant, and we'll know exactly if we got the whole $30,000, which I hope we do. I don't see why we wouldn't, but you never know. That will take up the rest of the funding money, plus a little more from some fund that I'll have to get with the mayor to get some money from. Then if we decide that we want to do some fall plantings, which I think we should continue to do that momentum, yeah, piggyback on the momentum we have this year, use the plants we already have in stock in the yard and the ones in Amherst for the rest of the spring planting, get those out of the way.
Yeah.
Inventory's rolling in. Next fall, we're back on the planting bandwagon. We're going to have to talk to the mayor about actually finding some money to transfer into the DPW budget or using existing DPW funds to pay for those trees. That's the only problem I see with that.
Yeah.
But those are all things that we should probably lay out on a timeline,
mm-hmm,
that we think we should do. And then we need to figure out what we're going to be able to do and what we can't do.
What about the money you collected through fines? It's almost $10,000.
Yes, that money is in there, but that could also be money that could be used to pay for tree inventory, that could be paid for trees. So there's all these little moving pieces to this whole
puzzle. Yeah. I mean, we talked, and you, I think you left the meeting early last week, so you missed this part, but we talked about how we really want the inventory to drive where we plant trees. And in fact, part of the inventory is going to be identification of sites. Mm-hmm. And then we want to select the right tree for the right site. So I think I heard consensus around the table that next year doesn't feel like the most important year for tree planting. It feels like the most important year for planning to plant trees. And that once we have a good plan, then we can take that to the mayor and ask for a really, really big chunk of money. And that would, I mean, here we're nickel and diming fees and things like that. Why don't we just put together a really compelling case for a large sum of money to be dedicated to tree planting and then plant them wisely?
I thought there was some money left over in the budget, though. I thought it was only $30,000.
Yes, the problem with that, though, is if we get the grant, we have to actually pay for, we'll have to encumber the money to pay for the services of whoever the vendor is.
Yeah.
And that'll take this year's monies that are in that line item.
Oh, because it's reimbursable.
Correct. So that way there, we will not have any money laid out in the DPW budget for tree planting.
Before June 30th, correct?
Before July 1st, correct.
Okay.
So what has to happen is that we have to have a plan in place of, say we want to plant another 150 trees,
yeah,
starting in September. We'll have to have a plan in place with a quote that says, Your Honor, can we transfer this amount of money, or can we utilize monies from other parts of the DPW Highway Division budget to pay for these?
Yeah.
Which he has said to me that please come back and see me if you need more money.
Mm-hmm.
So when we find out if we get the grant, we could possibly do it the other way. We could actually ask him to transfer money from free cash to pay for the grant. So that's totally separate.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a couple different ways to do this. It's just a matter of, A, do we get the grant to do the tree inventory? If we don't get the grant, do we decide to write a letter to the mayor as a group and pitch that we actually have the mayor fund the whole thing? Can you please find the money to fund the whole thing? This is very important, creates a baseline, and so on and so forth. We know how important it is, and I think he does as well.
Yeah.
That's another option. And if he decides to do that, then we still have money in the bank. Let's say we got $35,000 in the bank to purchase trees for next fall planting. So there's like, it's like kind of a moving target. Knowing if we're going to get the tree inventory is really the key piece to this, because that will determine how much money we're going to have left or where we're going to have to get the money from. But I think overall, we still need to have a plan,
mm-hmm,
in place that says we want to plant this amount of trees, this is what it's going to cost, and we need to find the money. And this has to be done sooner than later because of the actual order. The ordering has to be done.
Jen, I'm gonna let Jen speak, and then I'm gonna get us back on our.
I do think that we do need to, in the long term, drive our plantings you know, with the tree inventory, and I get that that's like the linchpin here, but I also do feel really, really strongly that we plant some minimal amount of trees in next fall. Even if it's, you know, we have to fundraise for 40 trees or whatever. I think we really have to keep going, partly because that's the public face of, even though we're doing tons of other things here, very clearly, and we've got a great relationship with the mayor, I think you have to keep, like, we've got these volunteers sitting there, like, I think we have to keep going.
Yeah. And I think,
and it doesn't have to be 100 trees or 200 trees or whatever. I get it. We're in this place of like, whoa, let's not get the cart before the horse. But I really think we still.
Well, this year, we planted a lot of trees right at the beginning. And so if we divide it over two seasons, it'll be a lot easier.
Right. Okay. Tree warden report.
Very quick, very easy. Two or three things I have on here is the Mass Tree Wardens and Foresters Association has their annual seminar, annual meeting in January. If anybody, 13th, 14th. So if anybody is interested in going, I will send you a link. I'll send you all a link to the actual conference so you can take a look at it. I'm going to be going for both days. If people want to carpool, Jay, you're going to go for both days. So maybe Jay and I can carpool, but I can take a few other people if you're interested in going.
Can you say when that is again?
Yep.
Yeah, I might be interested in going.
13th and 14th.
Yep.
That's Sturbridge again, is there?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, I might be interested in going.
So that was one item. The other item is just quickly the situation at 623 Kennedy Road. Right now, nothing is happening there. They have withdrawn they've taken their trench permit. Trench permits are over for the DPW, so there's no more construction in the public right away now because winter is here, blacktop plant's closed. So they have withdrawn their trench permit for the moment, taking their deposit back. However, I'm going to have to go work with them through the winter to figure out how we're going to get this accomplished because there was some kind of an incident that happened over the Thanksgiving weekend with an individual who almost got hit by those people pulling out of their driveway. Yes. He sent a very unfriendly email to the mayor's office, very unfriendly, and I actually think it was probably a relative or a friend of them because the gentleman had way too much information. He had too much information just to capture when you almost hit somebody. How are you? Okay? Thank you very much. Goodbye. So there's a lot of trees that have to come down. That's the problem. This is again the problem that these people went to planning because that's what they were told to do because of the location of their property. Planning approved it with certain conditions that they had. One little sentence says, all tree removals in the public right of way are covered by the DPW. So I got the plan at the very end. Mm-hmm. And the plan was not professionally done. So it didn't actually show the trees, all the trees that had to be removed. Usually I would put the onus on the individual homeowner to provide us with, you know, several sets of plans that show us how many trees have been removed in the public right of way. So it was really just kind of a mess from the beginning. I feel bad for the residents because I feel they feel as if they didn't get served well by the city. So I want to try to correct that if I can. So I'll be working with that, basically taking a survey of all the trees in the right of way, measuring them all, applying a formula to them, and going from there. So that's the only real big other tree issue. Other than we are a little short-handed this week. I had intentions of planting trees this week, but I have several people that are off. So we are supporting Rob's efforts to plant trees, which is awesome. Thank you, Rob. And then next week, we'll be out in earnest to get the rest of the trees in the ground. Possibly, we can do some planting on Friday. But tomorrow, we have to raise the stoplight structure on West Street for our annual exercise. So we're going to do 66 at all costs tomorrow.
I live on there. 79 West, across from the Veterans Field.
Oh, you'll be fine. You'll be able to get out. The road will be closed. We're going to close up the bridge.
Okay.
So, and that's really just our Tree City USA, which I'm working on, just gathering all the data that has to go into that. That's really about it, pretty short.
Okay, great. Is there any chance that you could stake those sites at the Northampton?
Yes,
East?
I sent you an email. I didn't know if you wanted to meet me out there.
Okay, great.
Maybe for, I don't know if you're available Friday. Just send me an email if you're available. And
all right.
We can just go
yeah, it might be.
Friday would be fine. Tomorrow, I won't be able to leave this job over here tomorrow.
This is for Friday's planting?
No, this is, I'm going to plant two more trees. I have permission to plant two more trees at the Community Music Center. You know, that very long they have. So mid-afternoon might work. Anything else?
No.
Okay. All right, so I have on the agenda here creating a manual. I just want us to start, you know, rendering ourselves obsolete so that when other people step in as commissioners, they won't be facing a blank, you know, a blank slate. So, and I think it makes sense that we house this thing just in a Google file.
Attaching it to the Google files we already have, or?
Yeah, do you have a folder? Do you have like a Google folder that we can have that is just entitled PSTC manual? And then you can share it with all of us, and that folder can contain all aspects of volunteer organizing. Like, you know, if we end up doing some kind of a spreadsheet on where our tree sourcing can happen.
I guess my question is, we don't want to combine it with the folder that you already have that has the volunteer list on it? Is that what?
Yeah, no, that could be. So all of these spreadsheets and documents could be contained in a Google folder. So in your Drive.
Separate folder.
In your Google, yeah.
Yeah, I think we should put it in a separate folder.
Separate folder from that. Folder.
Entitled yeah. PSTC manual.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, you can move some over or duplicate them or whatever. So does that feel like something you guys could do? Create a Google folder and then start depositing your stuff, and we'll put, like Marilyn would put the to-do list in.
Now I'm confused what the folder's for. It would not include that list that we have of volunteers? Or?
So this is something, this would become our manual. Our commission manual,
right.
And within it would contain all the documents that would help other people who us and people who come after us in their.
So why would Marilyn's list be in there?
Just like a template.
Good document.
Template. Okay. Yeah. Well, what about the? I'm just asking, like, what about the document that we created of the volunteers that you sent me an email and then I put it on a list?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were referring to a different one. Yes, that would go in there too.
Right. So we. Is that already in a folder?
No, it's not in the folder.
I see. Okay, yeah. So we should take that, put it in the folder.
Sure. Yeah.
Because there are a couple of lists, actually, of those kind.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them.
Yeah,
I just want them all to be housed in one place where we can all access them as our manual.
Right.
And Rob and I had a meeting about it, and we divided up those tasks. I just haven't had time to
get
on it yet. Okay, great.
So moving along, I mean, volunteer organizing. I want to, when I get the list complete, of course, send a letter to the people, as Jen mentioned, that have not volunteered, but we hold as prospective volunteers. And, you know, we'll just say, you'll hear from us later about possible spring and fall findings.
Mm-hmm. And waterings or, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Prunings.
Right. So that.
Right.
So that, and then the next thing is the sourcing of trees. And I just have a question about, I mean, we've sort of got it down to bare root and bags, right? So the only place I know where I can buy bags is Amherst Nursery. Does anyone in the room know other places where you can buy a tree and grow bag? No.
Is anyone willing from now until the next meeting to do some research on that?
You know, I've looked. I just thought someone might know.
I'm happy to reach out to Molly and ask her.
Yeah.
What she knows as sources.
Well, that's the closest place, you know. Mm-hmm. That's the closest place locally.
Oh, it's definitely the closest place.
And Bigelow is experimenting with it because they're starting to see a demand for it.
Uh-huh.
They usually do containers.
Right.
Those are the two that I work with.
I think it would be interesting to know if the tree warden in Amherst has had any experience with other growing. Do you want to do that?
Yeah. I'll contact Alan and Molly.
Yeah. I mean, he's had a shortage himself of trees occasionally, and there Amherst runs out for him too.
must think about that.
I'll also ask him about nursery. I don't know if, does anyone know if Amherst has a tree nursery?
I don't.
Okay.
You know, they had a sort of different mandate in that they were going to do it all pretty quickly. You know, I don't know, all is the right word, but they were going to plant, I think.
2,000 trees?
Yeah, in a very short period of time, so a nursery probably wouldn't work for them. So that's my interest in sourcing trees. I only know one place to get trees other than bare root trees, and that's Amherst Nursery. And bare root trees, I think, are definitely ruled out for fall planting, right?
Yeah.
They're not a possibility. So
bare root trees are not a possibility for fall?
I don't think so.
It depends upon when you dig them, you know, because if it's a fall, you know what I mean?
They just have to be dormant.
Right.
Yeah, but so if you plant them,
they're not dormant in the fall. I mean,
you can get them in the fall.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. The place
they hold them over through the hole.
No. It's just a different method that they dig them. So they won't dig them until they lose their leaves.
So it's like,
so
but you can get them. Yeah.
Really?
But there is a fall hazard list where it's not okay to dig.
Oh, totally. Right. Oh, yeah. Yeah. You can't. I mean, I get what you're talking about. There's species that do better spring digging.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Totally. No, but I mean, there's also
some that are totally fine.
So, some of the bare root places deliver for a fall.
The place that I research has two deliveries.
Right.
It has a spring delivery
spring
and a fall delivery.
Okay. Spring and fall, bare root. Okay, well, I'm just trying to get with the global world. The trees is pretty narrow at this point. I mean, it's not trees for
perhaps
fall. So, to-do list.
These are just these bullet points, Rob.
Right. I'm going
are just things related to the manual that we want to contain.
Yearly calendar, try and have something on the calendar is what we do each season.
So my question is, do we want to maintain a PSTC calendar? Yeah. So that we're always remembering, oh, it's late December, we need to start thinking about our spring planting list and get.
So this is related to planting, right?
This is all related to what the commission does. This whole thing is all these bullet points are just what we want to contain in our manual. This is like our Bible of what the commission does.
Right, I just said the bullet points all pretty much relate to planting trees.
This is why I have etcetera.
Well, tree planting, organizing, sourcing trees, organizing volunteers.
It's all under the heading of a manual. So, like, for example, if we want to have put any thought into what in the yearly calendar would be tending to specimen trees, you know, like, do we want to have, I don't know if there's a time of year when you treat elm trees for Dutch.
August.
Yeah, so I'm just talking.
So that would be on the calendar.
Yeah, I mean, right now I just my brain went to like things related to tree planting, but I'm just talking about everything that related to what the commission does. That we put it in a manual. It's like a vault.
So you're saying that's what they call standard operating procedure.
Yeah.
BMPs,
best management practice.
Best management practice. Yeah. So it'd be something that. So if we have another commissioner. We have a change of commissioners. You can hand that manual out to the commissioners and say, you know, this is what we do. You know, this is what our goals are. This is what our narrative is, and I think it makes sense.
Right. Okay. Well, that wasn't clear.
It provides a nice history too. The longer we exist.
Yeah.
We can have like an end of year report.
Yeah. I mean, given that this is our first year of existence, I just feel like thinking in terms of things like this is important. That we think in terms of systems. Okay. So that's it for a manual. Are there other aspects of a manual that people think that we should be thinking about?
Group agreement.
Good. Yeah.
Just our meeting schedule.
Group agreement. The other thing you should probably do is the commission can make its own internal rules and how it works. By the city.
Like bylaw?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Wouldn't the minutes all go in there? Or somewhere else?
They're already housed in the city website, so it would be duplication.
Yeah, it seems.
just a template of our agenda, you know. Any kind of template, I think is good. A list of all of our guest speakers.
Oh, yeah.
Do people use Google Calendars? Do we want to create something like a Google Calendar for the commission? I could also just do it as a spreadsheet where, you know, in January, these are the things to think about, February, these are the things.
I do a spreadsheet.
Spreadsheet.
I prefer a spreadsheet.
Okay.
It's just like one more layer there to refine.
Okay.
I know some people really like that.
Yeah, right. It's just a little messy.
It's just my personal, but, you know, if anybody else wants to do it, I would make myself do that.
Okay. All right. On to any other business. So two things that I moved from our conversation about the to-do list to any other business were discussion about the nursery and discussion about tree planting.
I would like to see a discussion about the nursery be an agenda item on the next agenda or an agenda after, so we have a larger chunk of time to talk about it, so we're not having to, because we only have like 15 minutes left.
Yep.
And then, what was the other one?
Tree planting. So just because I had to cut Rob off and say, let's talk about this during any other business. So Rob, was there any aspect of tree planting that you wanted to finish talking about?
Well, I guess that I feel that there are relationships with suppliers, there's the experience we've gotten. I mean, you can look at the trees that we planted, and our experience with B&B, and that's an experiment. So we keep experimenting. I think we keep moving forward. That's how we're learning how to plant better. I'm not sure that studying it will necessarily, it will add to, but in other words, waiting to study, I think is not a substitute for the infield experience of planting. So I really support continuing. I'm really happy if we can move to grow bags, but we don't even know if that's a good idea either. And I think, again, by experimenting, we're about to plant some this fall, some in the spring. We'll see how that goes. The bare root, same. We'll see how it goes. There is a project that Paige has proposed. I don't know if you're on that. Did she send you something? I asked her to send you something, but she probably hasn't done it. Where I had been working with Rich to plant some trees on North Street, and she objected because she wanted a different species, which are only available by bare root. And so I just said to her, not that I'm in charge, I said, if you want to do it, you should send a proposal in, because otherwise no one will even know that you're wanting that.
Do you want to do what?
Plant bare root trees. She has a selection of bare root trees that she wants to plant. She even offered to pay for them.
Okay.
So I guess I'm bringing it up. It seems like a minute detail, but I think this is the way to move into bare root, is to actually...
But the bare roots she's talking about are little whips, though.
No, I don't think so. I think that she's open to more substantial trees. And we can make it... We need to have an exchange with her to make that clear, that that's what we want, is more substantial trees. She's, you know, very excited about this and really wants to get a bunch of trees.
Are these setbacks or on the tree belt?
Tree belt.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, it's not that easy. She doesn't understand, you know, it'll be a process.
Uh-huh.
But if we want to do bare root, I think that we can study bare root, and we can study the tree bags, we can make lists and stuff, but actually doing it, I think, like getting a bunch of bare root in the ground this spring will help inform us as to how we deal with it, how well we deal with it. I mean, by reading about it, you know, you might think that B&B is the end all. I mean, cities all over the United States think B&B is great. But for them, maybe it is, because you can't steal them, so that might be why they do it, you know, in Cambridge. Whereas we probably don't worry as much about stealing them, or maybe people will start. So I guess I'm saying local experience is incredibly important. I mean, I did just set out some trees that were grown in grow bags, and I think someone could
pick them up and steal them. And Jay was saying people have stolen trees that have been just planted, so.
Oh, really?
At Smith, yeah.
Yeah.
That were in the ground?
Yeah.
They were in the ground, so I guess.
No kidding.
I'm really interested in trying the roots, because there are trees that we'll never get if we don't either have a nursery or bare root. I do think that the nursery, once we get it, will make the whole bare root thing a lot less important, because I think that with a nursery, we'll have the largest of possible selections. So I do see bare root as possibly slowing us down and diverting our energy, but because all this will be unnecessary once we have our nursery.
Okay, so I'm putting on the next meeting agenda, a more robust conversation about nurseries and sourcing. I want to disagree with you fundamentally about one thing. I think research is critical. And I'm not talking about just reading stuff, I'm talking about interviewing other communities that have done things and done them either poorly or done them well. And we learn from that. And that is so important, and it'll save us a lot of time.
There's a lot of research in this room already, that, you know, I mean.
But there's more, and why not just educate ourselves? Like,
totally.
What's the harm? Why not slow down a little bit? Because I just feel like I'm just like trying to hold back this sense of urgency that I don't think is necessary. I want to plant trees, but I want to do it. I don't want to take a little time to do it right.
I think that there is a huge amount of experiential knowledge. I mean, I think.
But less with bare roots. Four
people have in this room planted a lot of trees and been involved in tree programs, and so.
But I've even heard from them that we should learn a little bit more about this method.
I'm not for stopping. I guess what I'm saying is that learn a little more and get going too. In other words, I think getting Paige, for instance, to. Maybe maybe we expand on that and start a little program where we do some very, I guess, finding out which is the best and optimal, and not going into, and not moving forward until then is just a way of potentially losing out on the opportunity that exists now.
I don't think you need to worry about that. I think that we've demonstrated that we're moving forward at a really rapid speed. And I generally don't tend to be someone who just sits on my bum, you know? So I don't think that that's a worry you need to have. I have not felt
the support for the tree planting. I felt kind of like, well, it's an aside, it's a distraction. Whereas I feel it's an essential thing.
If I haven't expressed support for tree planting, I don't know how that has happened. I mean, we can have maybe a private conversation about that. That's surprising to hear, but I am just suggesting that we come to the table at the next meeting with some good information about the various options for sourcing and for some research about the value of having a municipal tree nursery, and that be a good starting point for making good decisions.
Yeah. Right.
Who's in charge of the research?
I'm certainly going to do some. I would love if people volunteer to do other aspects.
What format are you anticipating?
For the discussion?
The research.
The research? Well, I know what I usually do is I usually start with someone like Molly.
Yeah.
And ask her who to contact from, you know, first of all, I'll start with the open question of like, so we're looking for all the options for sourcing our trees. Mm-hmm. Who do you recommend that we go to or just speak with?
How's it to be presented?
How's what to be presented?
The data, the research.
Just around the table, just bringing it at the next meeting to the group.
Okay.
And then what we could do is we could put it on a spreadsheet.
I guess that's hard to, in other words, without having a sort of format of what a spreadsheet would be.
Okay, would you like me to make a template one?
Yeah.
And share it with the group?
I think so, because otherwise we'll come not really knowing.
Okay.
I mean, I think the problem is that there are so many variables and issues related to planting that it's hard for me to see exactly how it goes on a spreadsheet to make a comparison.
Okay.
We could just post, if you want to do it more old school, you could just post big sheets of, big pieces of paper.
Yep.
And just write pros and, pros and cons of each method. Because there is some intangibles, that are softer.
Right.
Or subjective.
So who's calling Molly?
Well, I'm happy to email Molly about the piece that I volunteered, which is to talk about nursery and, let's see, what do I have here? Yeah, I was gonna contact Molly and Alan to talk about the commercial nurseries that they use and recommend and municipal nurseries and whether they have
in the growth bags.
Yeah, I'm only gonna talk about growth bags here because it seems like that's where we're at.
Is anybody contacting the Chicopee people? Or somebody from Chicopee? That just...
I mean, I can talk to them pretty easily. I don't know, let's see. I can talk to DCR and talk to them about the program too. That's going up there.
I'm not asking us to drag this on, definitely. Really. I'm asking us to just spend a little bit of time now.
I guess it's like, I've spent the past 2 years immersing myself in the minutiae of all this stuff, so for me it just seems like a silly request to ask me to do it again,
You don't have to do it again, Andrew.
Yeah.
And I welcome all of the, experience you have related to this. So I'm not discounting anybody's experience or knowledge. I'm just saying that the municipal nursery thing is interesting to me to hear from communities that have done it for, almost a decade. We attempted a municipal nursery in this town and we failed. So like, clearly it's not all, it's not all roses, a bed of roses, because it proved to be harder to manage than we had.
Is this the resources place?
We had. No, this is when we tried to partner with Voke.
That's what I'm saying, the Voke.
Oh yeah, I faced the Voke. Yeah, so I mean, to me, and I know you've established a good tree nursery. You have a much bigger budget than Northampton has.
I have no budget.
But I thought you got a big grant.
Yeah, it's all from the state. It's all by hook and crook, It's all me cobbling stuff together and getting money from outside funding sources. I have $0.
Yeah.
I have my staff time. That's it.
I did go through some of the costs for that. And a lot of them don't apply, I don't think, to Northampton. Most of the expense had to do with equipment that we wouldn't be buying.
Yeah. And my budget is non-existent.
All right. But do you see the rationale to me wanting to speak to communities that have been doing it for a while?
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Okay.
I mean,
because I'm sensing this resistance to doing research, and I'm a little bit flummoxed by that.
Well, I think we started out by talking to Al Snow.
Not about municipal nurseries or how he sources his trees. At least I have.
Okay. He buys his stuff from Amherst Nurseries. That's where he buys it.
Mostly, yeah.
I mean, I guess I've run into him three or four times and talked to him about trees.
Well, bring that to the table next week.
In other words, it's not like we don't want to know all this. I guess the problem is that I'd like to see it done where the research is done in such a way that it doesn't preclude making sure that we're able to keep moving forward with what we do have. We have certain things that like we can have fewer trees and grow bags. We're not going to get enough anyway, I don't think. So in other words, we're going to have to fill in anyway. But I'd like to see us continue to say, okay, there are good things about what we've done so far in the last year. We want to keep doing some of that. That's all. I'd like to feel like
okay. So, does anyone want to volunteer for any more aspects of researching municipal nurseries or sourcing trees in other ways?
What I'd like to do is have, after you've spoken to Molly and Alan. If they give you any leads as to where we might get trees and tree bags, I'd like to call those people.
In grow bags?
Yeah, because even if they say that, they've gotten them here or there, doesn't mean that we'll actually get any.
Okay,
so
all right.
Would you be willing to just like, present what you know. I mean, I totally get it. You've done it, you know? So I would just like to hear, oh, this is the way we've done it, this is how, you know, and you've had your own nursery as well at Smith. So I think, you know, that would be useful to me, anyway, to hear from you folks who, you know, pulled it off.
Yeah, I guess that's what I was referring to about the knowledge in the room, is that we actually have two people that built nurseries in the room, so that would probably be my first place where I'd like to see information.
Okay, well, how would you, so do you guys want me to give you 15 minutes each to, like, make a presentation?
Would that take that long, but...
I could do it pretty fast, yeah.
Yeah, just, yeah, enough time to go through my whole process of thinking of the different aspects and how my experience and your experience.
I went to see yours over the weekend, just out of curiosity. I tracked down where it is, you know? It looks nice, looks really nice, too.
Yeah, we've got a lot of trees to come out this spring.
Yeah.
Oh, it's weird.
I can see why that would be a desirable place to sell, you know, considering the fact it's in the
Well, that's on hold now.
So I think then what we've got is a couple presentations about maybe having a tree nursery. I'll try and find out after you as much as I can about what we could get in terms of grow bags. And then you will try and find out as much as possible about what we can get in terms of bare root.
I can do that, yes. So I will work on bare root and trying to get an interview from Lexington and any other community that's been doing municipal nursery for a long time. I'm also going to ask the question of, you know, those communities that have, that are our size or bigger, that have chosen not to have municipal nurseries. I'd like to understand why.
Lexington is really wealthy. It's kind of a super wealthy.
But Ed Casey has one in Springfield too, you know, so Lexington has rolling cash.
Oh, good cash. He does.
You know, and we went down and talked to him about his, you know, and it's pretty low drama, you know, it's just like behind his barn, you know, he put trees there.
Yeah.
He's the past president of the Municipal Arborist Association. So.
I'm just saying, Lexington might have spent money that we don't need to spend, and they might have...
Well, it's useful information to have, though, that, you know, oh, we can't do it because we don't, you know. And then, just one, underneath that tree, you talked about a business plan kind of thing. I just want to say that the Small Farm Institute in Belchertown, like, they, like, run this whole thing about business plans. It'd be, you know, if we end up wanting to go that route of having something documented, they have this whole package that you just go there and they help you. I mean, I've never personally done it, but, you know, we don't have to.
It's more related to farms, though, right?
Yeah, that a nursery, it's any ag business, small ag. It could be like the guy who does real pickles, you know, did that.
Okay.
So.
All right.
Any ag related?
No. I'm not sure we'll have time at the next meeting to discuss business planning, but
just put that in the hopper. Yeah, like I think if we do decide to go that route, then somebody should talk to them, because I think it could really shortcut the amount of messing around we did.
Business plan implies that we're putting together a plan that we take to the mayor. Is that for money?
Yeah.
Do you have any kind of template we work with for that?
Not for a nursery. Or, I mean, like a business plan in general, or just like related to a nursery.
In general, that we could tailor.
I might be able to come up with a business plan.
I want. Maybe you have a better idea of what the mayor means by that.
Yep. It's probably something similar to a much smaller scale of a stormwater utility. So the stormwater utility had to be a model that said that, you know, stormwater utility fees are going to be self-supporting the stormwater utility by user fees. So there may be a business plan that we could pull some things out of to make our own. So I'll ask Jim, the city engineer.
Okay. All right. Can we have a to-do recap?
Yeah. Really? Yep. Again, let me know if I missed anything. Okay, Lily is going to create a card for the mayor for next meeting. Thanking him for tree planting. Rich and Lily contact Smith vocational graphic designer regarding door hangers for tree watering, perhaps also for setback planting. I have a letter to mayor regarding DPW ED hire. Is somebody assigned to that, or is that just?
I'm happy to draft something.
Okay.
I would bring it back to the committee.
All right.
And you say that we have at least through January?
Four.
Before the mayor is even going to be turning his attention to a new hire?
It's going to be, I would say it's probably, I'm actually just reading an email from Ned, actually says I resigned as Director of Public Works. And I have a limited future contact through my email to the end of the year.
He's gone?
I don't really know what that means. I mean, that would mean to me that he has resigned as of...
Now?
Immediate effective meeting.
Possibly today. I'm not sure. This has been a very...
Does that mean you're the new guy?
No, it doesn't mean anything. I'm still the tree warden. No, it doesn't mean anything. It's got to be, I don't know what's going to happen. This is what our meeting about is next week, so... I would say I will know more after. I'll have more information for you probably at the next meeting.
It'll be about the Gazette tomorrow, I'm sure.
Well, it is in the Gazette.
It's in the Gazette today.
Yeah. It's in the Gazette today.
Okay.
All right, so Rich is going to send the committee the link for the tree wardens and foresters.
Done.
Done, all right.
That's what we were talking about.
Bye-bye.
Lily and Rich are doing tree plantings this Friday. Jay and Rob create a Google folder for the Public State Tree Commission manual. Lily contact Alan and Molly regarding Amherst Nursery grow bag sourcing. Lily create spreadsheet template for tree sourcing and nursery research.
I think I'm going to skip that because it sounds like people want to give presentations.
Okay.
Is that what I'm hearing?
Well, whatever information people have, bring it to the table.
Yeah.
Bring it to the table. Okay, I will keep it, and then maybe as you give your presentations, I'll be popping stuff into a spreadsheet. I'll also send it on. Never mind.
Okay, tomorrow.
We'll keep that on there.
Jay and Andrew, brief presentations next meeting regarding the establishment of their programs. And Rich asked Jim, the city engineer, regarding a template for a business plan that we could perhaps adopt.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Thank you. All right. Motion to adjourn this meeting. Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.